Okay, I want you to have in your mind, taped in on your brain, Christ saying, I have come to give them life so that they may have life and have it abundantly. Okay, so the following of Jesus Christ in the spiritual life, in the sacramental life, and in the moral life is always about the fullness of life. So God is there to give us the best possible way of living. So with that in mind, I want to talk about sin. Okay, this is a heavy topic. We don't like to talk about sin. We often see sin as something that puts a burden on us, makes us feel bad, heavy, guilty, shameful, and so forth. But I want us to look at sin using the image of a fruit tree. And I'm using that image from my namesake, James, in our second reading. You know, we are the first fruits of God's creation. Okay, a fruit tree. So say you are struggling with the sin of gossip. Okay, gossip or impatience. Those are two sins I hear a lot, and I myself am guilty of them, right? So you just go to confession, you say, okay, I sin, I commit gossip, or I'm impatient. If we just look at sin and if we just stop right there, it's not enough. Life is a burden. The gossip is the fruit, okay? So the pear, if you will. What then is the tree that's producing the pear? The tree that produces the gossip is, think of the seven deadly sins, something that you're struggling with, more of a tendency. So you're angry or you're lacking charity, envious, lustful, whatever it might be, okay? So that's the next step that we take. We identify the sin, we go to the source of the sin, which is the tree, but that's not it for the tree, right? There's something deeper in the tree, and that is the root. What is the root that is causing the anger or the envy? So maybe it's insecurity. Maybe it's a fundamental self-doubt or mistrust of who you are or of who God is, that God created you just as he wants you. You don't believe that, right? So there's something, a root within you that's producing the vice or the sinful tendency, and that it's leading to the fruit. So we don't just want to stop and say, oh, I committed gossip, but we want to go deep. And the way we go deep, obviously, go to the sacrament of reconciliation, of course, but prayer. Okay, so you catch yourself gossiping a lot or being impatient a lot. Okay, what's going on in your heart? That's where Jesus wants to meet you. That's getting into your heart. And that's what Moses is saying, and then the Lord is saying to the Pharisees. Okay, a God of just the pure law, an external religion, isn't a God that wants to get into your heart. He just doesn't want you to gossip anymore. But that's not Jesus Christ. That's not the Father, the Holy Spirit that we know. The Father, Son, and Holy Spirit want to be intimately in you, getting to those roots, those wounds, those core wounds, and helping heal you so that you can live in freedom and have the abundance of life. Amen.